Hello learners, welcome to this video on development communication models, theories and approaches to sustainable development goals. In the previous unit, we learned about participatory approaches and sustainable development goals. In this unit, we are going to study about how development communication affects the knowledge, behavior and attitude levels of the people in general. First of all, let us look at the objectives of this unit. At the end of this unit, we will be able to elaborate upon the concept, nature and scope of development communication, see what really development communication is as a concept, as philosophy and as its definition, also the characteristics and types of development communication, the core areas of development, especially in the Indian perspective, and the role and significance of media for development communication. And finally, we will be able to reveal some key development campaigns. So as an overview, let us understand the term development communication, which begins with the word development, which in itself means positive change or changing for better. When we say development communication, we really mean a system of communication that is used for strengthening of human society in different fields of life, because overall, humans are all about development. We have been evolving, we have been civilizing, we have been developing and growing. So yes, the aim is to help the humankind and the universe as a whole, in totality, grow and develop. So far as the development communications definition is concerned, my personal favorite is this definition given by Nora Kubrel in 1975. Nora Kubrel is the person who coined the term development communication back in 1975, and she more or less said that it is an art and science of human communication applied to the speedy transformation of a country and the mass of its people from poverty to a dynamic state of economic growth, ultimately to make possible the greater social equality and the larger fulfillment of human potential. Now, we want to understand the function of development communication. Before we delve into understanding the function, I would like to bring to you here this one example, probably, which as a whole can help us understand these functions in their totality. So this example is called the introduction of biogas plant in India. We all must definitely have heard about biogas plant. So what really it is, for those who may not be really aware of it or may not be knowing it, so as the name suggests, biogas is gas produced biologically using organic things, starting with dung. So it is dung, the excreta of the animals, the cattle raised by farmers on their fields. This dung usually goes into making those dung cakes, which are ultimately used as fuel. And it creates a lot of smoke, pollution, and also health hazards to the users. So the idea was to bring in a plant wherein this dung could be put into a system wherein it will not only bring out compost or manure to replace the pesticides or fertilizers which were chemically produced, but also bring out gas, because that fermentation, that process produces gas. So this gas can then be taken through a pipe to a stove, wherein it not only replaces the LPG, the usual gas that is used for cooking, but also it is organic. It does not have that kind of impact of environment, which depletes it. So it is more environment friendly. And then there have been cases noted in the states of Haryana and Punjab, which are still there, wherein this gas, big farmers, or I should say zamindars, have used biogas plants to produce electricity, and they are actually supporting almost the entire village with that electricity, because the gas produced ultimately was so much that could run a turbine, or that could run that generator to produce electricity or bring out water, etc. So even further benefits have been found. But then this example in itself states this function of development communication as we begin and understand that spreading and not dumping of information. So when biogas plant was introduced to the farmer in the beginning, it was not acceptable. It was something that was bringing the farmer out of his or her comfort zone. They had to do something different, you know. They had to set up a plant, then they had to take things to that plant, put that pipeline, bring it to the kitchen. So that routine was being disturbed, even if that was made easier, made convenient, the farmer was still not ready to change. So the information initially that was sort of dumped, it was realized later that it needs to be spread properly. The sustainable development needs to be created ultimately. The approach has to be people-oriented and holistic. The strength and culture promotion and heritage preservation needs to be done, which means we cannot take the farmer away from the regular routines of the farmer's life, and also how that self-realization and self-reliance, the participation in this program is going to benefit the farmer, was supposed to be told. So all this was done with the help of various tools of communication, like television advertisements were created, pamphlets were printed for the people who could read. Field workers or extension workers were hired who would go to the field. They were trained in training people further. And mostly these field workers were people from amongst that strata of society. People were picked from there, trained, and then sent back by the agriculture universities. So such things, such tools were utilized. And then there was folk media also utilized, like street three theaters were performed, etc. So all these tools were used, and the function of development communication was achieved in this one example. There are so many, many more examples as you will go on researching and searching. Moving on, definitely we want to understand, first of all, the growth and progression of development communication in India, wherein we want to begin with radio. The first one was Radio Club of Bombay, which started in June 1923 in India. And then later on, when independence was achieved, there were 6 radio stations in India: Delhi, Bombay, Calcutta, Madras, Tiruchirappalli, and Lucknow. At that point in time, only 11% of the population was covered. Only 2.5% of the area was covered. In 1956, then it was converted into Akashvani. There were Vivid Bharti services which came into being in 1957. Today, almost 92% of the total area is covered. In fact, maybe beyond that. This is some data which I have procured, but definitely I'm saying it's approximately 92% of the total area that is covered. So how radio has benefited, what tool radio has become, we will definitely look at that. But before that, we will also see that the television also came into being in 1959. It was Doordarshan, which was launched in Delhi. The famous programs were Krishi Darshan, and there are other programs which were famous in that point in time that were looking at the development communication of India, because that was the only channel, only TV channel, and people suddenly got attracted to the television. They would stick to the television, sit there and watch. So it was realized that video was a more effective medium. So more and more programs were being broadcast. And then the satellite television came into being in 1975, wherein cable TV, etc., came into being, more channels came into being, more regional programs were being broadcast, and more people were being reached out to. Only Hindi was not the language that was used for a telecast and broadcast, but other regional languages were also used, which gave that touch, you know, in development communication. That localized touch is very, very important. You really need to touch the hearts of people. You really need to go to the core of the hearts of the people with the help of their culture, their heritage, whatever they do and perform in their language. If possible, we want to talk to these people in the languages that they speak. Then came print media, wherein it was very, very active pre-independence and post-independence. Pre-independence, the agenda were eradication of poverty, disease, illiteracy, superstition, and of course the freedom struggle. So print media was used by these journalists and freedom fighters, Gokhale, Bal, Gandhiji, there was Raja Ram Mohan Roy, and so on and so forth. These all talked about the social evils and also talked about the independence, the benefit of independence, why we should be independent, etc. They made people aware through these campaigns. Even if people were illiterate, the people who were literate would take those printed material to the people, read it out to them, tell them what is written, etc. Folk songs were made, poems were made which would touch people's hearts, patriotic songs were there, and that is how the tools of development communication were used through print media to touch people's heart. Post-independence, of course, the focus was on developing, because for so many past slaved years, we had lost everything. We did not have anything in hand now. We had to start from scratch. India was known as the golden bird at one time, and then we were left with nothing. We had nothing at all. So we had to bring up the people of India. We had to develop them. So 5-year plans, Panchayati Raj, industrialization, Chipko movement, Neel Darpan case, all these things were happening in that point in time. And print media was playing a very, very effective, crucial role. Also because of its nature, print media, the paper is foldable, is portable, it is easily carryable. So it was easier for people to carry it from one place to the other and preach things, whatever was written to people from one place to the other. Then also there was traditional media. There is traditional media, also known as folk media. There are so many forms which you might have already heard: street play, Lavani, Sang, Ragini, Bhavai, Chopai, puppet show, etc. And there are so many more. These are always used, as I've just talked about them. So we always used these skits, the street theater as humor, the other satire, the other emotions are used to reach out to the people. Plays are created, enacted, situations are enacted in such a manner that people be aware of the situation and also of the remedies, the problem and the remedies at the same time. There have been challenges in development communication. So when we began after independence, suddenly we were clueless. We did not know what to do. So new skills had to be taught to people at low cost, because of which, or for which actually, the agricultural universities were introduced in India. One of them is Punjab Agricultural University, there is Haryana Agricultural Universities, and now there are so many more public universities and private universities that are dedicated to agriculture and ultimately development. Why agriculture, and why I'm specifically talking about the agriculture universities? We all now know that India is an agriculture-based country. India is a country which is very rich in natural resources. So these universities had to tap that potential of the farmer to come out and talk about commercialization and come out of that cocoon of only producing for the family and for the local people. So these were the challenges that were fought at the cost of course, at very low cost, at the cost of nation's economy in that point in time. We had to compromise with some aspects of economy so that we can gain in the long run. One solution that was provided, one tool that was provided as a solution in that point in time is comics. So comics were given out to people, children who would read them. And because there were also the caricatures, the visuals, so the message was easily conveyed. More solutions were the agencies, development agencies like Department of Agriculture were established, voluntary organizations came into being, concerned citizens were there, and non-governmental organizations or NGOs as we know them. We come to the approaches to development communication, and here are various different approaches which we will look at one by one. Let us look at the first one, which is diffusion or extension approach, wherein we only want to diffuse whatever innovation has come into being. One latest example that we can take is the vaccine for COVID. The technology came into being, the innovation came into being, and now it had to be stressed to the people, reached out to the people, and we wanted more and more people to take the vaccine. Initially, it was seen that people were not taking the vaccine, but then development communication tools were used, like spreading out information through television, newspaper, doctors, community radios, All India Radio, so on and so forth. So people were reached out, people were told the benefits, people were told how, if they will not go for the vaccine, what will happen, if they will go for the vaccine, what will happen, etc. So that innovation was diffused or extended to people with the help of various tools, and also field workers or extension workers. Then we have the mass media approach, wherein mass media is used, as I told you. So television, radio, print media, and social media, or I should say new media, is used. Development support communication approach is there, wherein support takes place with the help of something that goes beyond mass media, as I talked about, the extension workers. So the people are hired who then take those mass media messages further to the people who were not either able to access the mass media messages, or they were not so interested in listening or taking it from the mass media. The institutional approach, I mentioned the universities, for example, the agricultural universities, and now most of the educational institutions, non-governmental organizations, even organizations, the corporate sector is talking about the corporate social responsibility towards the sustainable development goals. Because we want to sustain the world, we want to utilize the current resources in a manner that we are able to sustain them for long term. So all the development measures are being taken care of through these development communication tools that I have named, ultimately to achieve the sustainable development goals. We have the integrated approach, wherein the integration of all these tools and technologies together takes place. The rural and urban are brought together, the backward and forward are brought together, and that is how the development communication we try to achieve through participation. Localized approach is the participatory approach, wherein people, they perform, they enter, like e-Chopal, e-governance, all these are the latest examples wherein the farmer or the people on the local grounds are involved in the development measures, and tools that are used to spread to them, to the people, are more interpersonal tools rather than the mass media tools. So all sorts of communication tools are utilized. And we have the planned strategy for development communication, wherein in a proper planned manner, we have radio, TV, press, etc. working for development communication. So this is how we learned that with the help of development communication tools, methods, and approaches, we will be able to achieve the sustainable development goals ultimately, and we will be able to see how development communication helps. Ultimately, the communication through mass media, through these methods and tools, helps in achieving this faster and further. In the next video, I will explain to you how to utilize these tools and how these tools actually have been helping people and how they can help us, how we can utilize these tools. Till then, see you. Bye-bye.